Welcome aboard, sailors. I'm Captain Punkin, and I'm hungry for some Dark Souls 3 Tower DLC. Or, what's it called? The Ring City. Not the Ring Tower. It's the Ring City DLC. Yeah, but I'm wondering where that guy is. You know, he was on this balcony, and now I can't find him. I want to know what happened to him. I'm curious, and his armor is pretty cool. You know, I want to know who he is. I want to know stuff. Damn it. So, I was already checking down that way. I'm going to head back down and check out the catacombs, because I'm thinking that's where he wound up, in the catacombs. And maybe he got eaten by the dragon. Who knows? Ooh, I found something. There's a wraith out here. Just out here wandering around. Look at that. Hey, can I talk? Do you want to talk? Oh, he wants to fight. Drop anything interesting? Titanite slab. That's pretty cool. So there's an extra Titanite slab over here. I just that's the main building where you come out, so you just circle around and look around the building, and there's just a frickin' dark wraith wandering around. That's fun. Ooh, I found something! I really found something! Wow! Curiosity. Hello?
I've searched for thee. Dark, stricken creature. I am Shira, daughter of the Duke, descendant of gods, and trusted friend to Midir. At once, I am the honor of the gods, the glory of fire, and the fear of the dark. Thou shalt not go unpunished for thy treachery, thy profanity, and thy shameless yearning.
Okay. Crazy hammer, though. You! Oh, that's annoying. That's really fucking annoying. Oh, and she can heal too. You bitch! Well, you're out. I don't care. Dumbass. There's another one. Ooh, Titanite's Lab. Again. Another one. Sacred Chime of Filianor. Okay. What's this? What does this say? These chimes do interest me. Okay, pray for favor. Works with chimes equipped in the left hand, left or right hand. Heal HP very slowly for duration of time. Affects caster and those in vicinity. Ooh, that's interesting. Sacred Chime expands the range of vicinity, affecting miracles that heal, cure, or provide other enhancements. Oh! So, this one lets you not only heal yourself, but people around you, too. Blessed by Princess Filianor, Matriarch of the Church. That is interesting. A crossfear hung with a malformed corpse. Once a mad king was born to the pygmy royalty, and Shira, Knight of Filianor, put him to rest. But Shira's crossspear, unable to kill the undying king, only pinned itself to him. Shira delivered them together to a dark room where she stayed and held them close. That's crazy. Mad King's Folly. Slam malformed corpse into the ground to briefly awaken it, then fillet with strong attack to trigger a roar. A blessing or a vexation. So it's random. So it's a Wabbajack. Let's take a look at it. Hold on. That is not a cross spear, that is a halberd. See? There are cross spears, which is just a spear with two spikes on the side. Then there's a halberd, which is a spear with an axe and a spike on the back. And that's a halberd. And that is not a pygmy skull. Whatever happened to that pygmy, that's, wow. This thing's twisted. I kind of like it. Oh, it's a hammer. It's an axe that acts like a hammer. I kind of like it. Terrari has an affinity for halberds, so it's kind of appropriate. Now, hold on, you. Yeah, there we go. It's very entertaining. It's for some reason, it's just really entertaining. Yeah, but it makes me fat roll too, so I gotta get rid of it. At least for now. So that's interesting. There are still things here to look for. So it's not as bad as I thought it would be. So it's not as terrible, awful, redundant as I thought. So if you check to the left, this is where you come in, I believe. Yeah, this is the area where you get in. So you start from here, and then you can go out. If you go to the right, if you cling to the right wall, then you'll find that area where we just were, where we fight Eleanor's knight. And if you go to the left, then you can find the free Titanite slab. But Eleanor's knight also gives you a Titanite slab, so win-win. Oh. Now this is interesting. Before, this door was left closed. And I was running through the DLC again, and look and behold, Shira. The lady that we were speaking to before was Shira. The person who we fought back at the boss's encampment, that was this person. Ah. So intriguing. Ouch! I just got roasted alive by this random dude. Like, I just got comboed to hell! That's Dark Souls for you. There goes 76,000 souls. Yeah, seriously, is that what Framped really looks like? I guess no one ever sees their head, so people just keep thinking that the serpents, they have like these weird body shapes. Because no one ever sees their body, so so it's kind of left to imagination, so the artists just keep telling people other stuff. Oh, its eyes are missing. I just realized that. Like half of the head is frickin' broken off. But that's definitely Framped. Or Calf. It's probably Calf, because his name is Darkstalker, right? And then King Seeker Framped. Vati Vidya, that's who I'm thinking of. That's who I was trying to remember earlier. For anyone who wants to know more about this world, look up Vati Vidya. Alright? Because he knows more than anybody about this stuff, man. I think the producers actually went to Vati to figure out what their game actually meant. Like, what everything meant. Just to put everything together. Because what they do in this game is they just make the bosses, but then they throw in the lore behind them afterwards, I think. I think that's how it works. Like, there are certain aspects of the boss that they decide afterwards, but in general, like they have to make a general assumption at some point. Where are my souls? There they are. Nope. You scratched the hell out of me last time. Bad kitty. Hey guys, I actually just found something very important. From this bonfire, which is, which one is here? The ringed inner wall bonfire. I just found the elevator that goes up, and it's actually really well hidden. Because I never thought to look back at this point in time, but it's right next to the statue of Gwyn. So I was focusing so much on the statue that I didn't realize there were two doors back here. This is where you come up from the catacombs. So you'll be coming through here, and then if you turn around, boom, elevator. Makes it a whole lot easier to get back here. Probably. Maybe. Most likely. Yeah. So, yeah, there's that. But that also begs the question, how the hell did you get up there? And what is it? Oh, maybe there's a secret room upstairs. So let's head back. So now that we know where we are... Aha! I figured it out. I just figured it out. I just saw what it is. Haha! I did it! Any traps, any tricks, any pickup sticks? Eh, it's just an ember. Now let's see what this is. Ooh, it's a good one! It's a Chloranthi ring plus 3! Oh, that would have been so helpful in the boss fight. Oh man, that's one of the major rings. It increases your stamina recovery speed. Oh man, it's the most powerful version. Oh, that would have been so helpful. Oh, biggie one right there. Yeah, good. That one belonged in Lord Gwyn's hands. Damn. He turns himself into a discus. No. You know what? For that one, I'm gonna rate that one good. Because that one was cleverly placed. Because all of these are illusionary walls. There's three in a row. Three in a frickin' row. All along here. So, it's like, illusionary wall, another one. It's like sarcasm. So, I'll give that one a good rating. What the? Oh, shit. Hello! Suddenly, dragon. What the hell? There's a new one by me. I'm doing like no damage to this thing. Really? I should have some lightning urns. These will hit it pretty hard. Because it's a dragon. Nope, it doesn't give a shit. Is that thing blind? Okay, so I just took out the dragon. What do I get for it? Safe zone? Well, yeah. But I just spent a long time taking out a dragon. Where is it? Did it just fall off the face of the earth? Better fucking not have. I wonder if it can respawn. I mean, it gave me a buttload of, well, actually, it didn't really give me all that many souls. I just wanted to know what happened if I did. Welcome aboard, sailors. I'm Captain Punkin, and I'm hungry for some Dark Souls 3, DLC tidbits. Ooh, interesting. Oh. Yes, I'm calling this the tidbit series because this is going to be all about things that I missed on the first run through. Like that, I didn't know that was going to be there. Anywho, there's a spell that I want for Tora called, Great Dreg Heaps or something like that. Great Dreg, Darkness Dregs or whatever. Great Dreg Heap, what was I thinking? Okay, I never got that. But that's not what I'm actually looking for, you'll see. Like, a Great Dreg Soul, I believe. There we go, that sounds more like it. I believe that I just missed it last time around. Yes. But that's basically what it should do. It's a little bit simpler. A rusted coin. It should be somewhere around here. Okay, that's a titanite chunk. There's a murky long staff. Oh. I couldn't deal with the swarm of enemies. So sad. But where is it? It's a spell. I looked it up on Wiki and it said that this is where it would be. And I'm having some trouble finding it. Let me see. One moment. Ah. Yes, I was on the right track. I was very close, but I missed it by a millimeter. Treasure ahead. Oh, there is treasure over here. Extra ember. Well, we can always use those. Here we go. And I certainly want to get those souls back, because that was a large investment. I'm soul grinding at the moment to take on, Mimir. Dark Eater Mimir. Or whatever his name is. Mimir. Mimir. Whatever his name. The dragon. Okay, so we head through here just like last time. But we ignore those two, because, you know, it takes them forever to get started. We'll be halfway to Candace by then. And it's right here, and this is what we missed. Now we just run through here, that douchebag will summon a bunch of guys, or he'll chase us down. Take the ladder. Dodge like hell. And there we have the great soul dregs. Wait a second. I just noticed something. Aha. Almost missed a secret. Ooh, that's a good one. As a matter of fact, I could use that right now. The covetous silver serpent ring. Fallen foes yield more souls. I've been using one. The lesser version. But that will come in handy with my grinding. I wasn't even expecting to find that. What a treat. Alright, thank you for your time. Is there anything in here? It looked a bit bright over here, so I just assumed that there was something glowing over here. Alright, thanks for watching, sailors. You can help me burn cancer by clicking here. Join my crew if you're hungry for more, and I'll see you all in the next one. Sail on. Okay, just checking really quick. What happens when we give her the old woman's ash?
Well, what warm, humble ash have we here? It's as if thy fate were with death entwined. But take no note of me. Thy business is thine own. As by now thou surely knowest, there is little I love more than a gratuity of souls.
Did you detect sarcasm in that? Yes, I have yet to use the church doodad. It might be fun. Playing as a boss for a while. It could be fun. Okay, we have 6 titanite slabs. That is no small number. Here we go. Great Dark Soul Dregs. A sorcery that fires great dark soul dregs that have stewed for ages far within the deep. This sorcery is the highest form of a deep soul. Some of the merkmen who rise from the depths are possessed by soul dregs which have a grave likeness to the human form. So I'm currently leveling things up. I can currently use the Dark Edge.
Ashen One.
Or rather, Tora can. But I'm currently leveling up, and I'm actually, I hit 120, I'm actually going to respec and put 1 point over into intelligence so that I can use the Great Soul Dreg. That is what it was called, right? Yeah, the Great Soul Dregs. Because you see, you need 40 intelligence to use this spell. And it's really something. Once I get there, I'll show you what it looks like. See you then.
Welcome aboard, sailors. I'm Capn Punkin, and I'm hungry for some more Dark Souls 3, The Ring City DLC. We're back with Tora, and as I thought, we hadn't seen the last of that dragon. I had to look it up, though. It's really hard to find, and normal people will not find this on by any means. You would be very lucky to get a hold of it. Its name is Midir, Dark Eater Midir. Ironic that Terrari happens to be a goddess of darkness and we're fighting something called Dark Eater. On top of that, it's a dragon. And Tora's a dragon as well. And everyone knows a dragon's favorite meal is another dragon. Sorry, Tora. You seem to be at a disadvantage. Well, you notice this place right here? There's a statue matching that statue right there. Here, you smack it. And it opens the gateway. And there will also be a doodad right here on that corpse. I just now opened it. I haven't actually gone down to the boss just yet. I wanted to make sure that I was recording first. This boss is supposed to be harder than the last boss. I'm not sure what anyone meant. Is it Frampt or Kath? I don't know. Kingseeker Kath or Darkstalker Frampt? I don't know. But basically, we take the tumble down here, and it begins. Now, I was warned that I'll need to have high fire defense, so I equipped a fire shield in place of my charms. And fortunately, this is also the Shield of Want. So I can also ignite my blade whenever I want, and I can just hold it up as will. So, here we go. Whew! And there's the big bastard right there. Wait. What the? Oh yeah, that's from the Shield of One. I noticed the silver snake symbol. Dark Eater Midir. Now this is supposed to be one of the tougher bosses in the game at this point in time. Okay, he's got a health bar.
How pleasant. Oversized heat waves. What the hell? Bit more than I bargained for. So what they really meant was oversized hitbox. I'm having a really hard time actually landing my blows. That tail swipe is, it hits way too hard. Bullshit. Bullshit. That's bullshit too, because you can't avoid it. It's an entirely different kind of boss fight than from the previous one. I'm not gonna get used to that. But look at how much damage I've actually done throughout the entire fight so far. That's just a stupid hitbox. That's just plain dumb. This is one of the problems with modern gaming. An oversized hitbox. easiest way to make a boss extremely difficult: jack up its attack power and make its health bar insanely huge. It's simple. The developers don't have to think at all about it. They just have to jack up anything from normal. They don't even have to think about it. They can just think, okay, we're gonna have this boss have 1 million fucking health, and you can only do about 50 damage per hit. All right, yay! Have fun!
Thanks for watching, sailors! You can help me burn cancer by clicking here! Join my crew if you're hungry for more, and I'll see you all in the next one! Sail on!